Hello, LBSEA members. This is Will Potter, president of the association. I hope your summer's going well and you're enjoying your time with your family and friends. I want to share with you an important message regarding our contract and the status of negotiations. The Board of Education and the LBSEA have reached an agreement. Now, all changes are available for your review on our website. Now, as many of you know, we tried to meet at the end of the school year. However, due to factors beyond our control, that meeting did not have the desired outcome we had hoped for. So the best way to get this information out to you was to make this movie. We hope that you watch it from the beginning to the end, as it contains a lot of information, and it might answer some of the questions you might have about this proposed contract. You know, this agreement contains major schedule changes for the middle school and the high school. So in order to ensure a smooth and successful transition for staff and students, a ratification vote needs to be held during the summer and prior to the opening of school. Therefore, we have scheduled 6 informational and voting sessions on August 7th, 8th, 9th, 12th, the 13th, and the 14th. Now, details about these sessions will be sent to you via district email and will be posted on our website. All of these meetings will be held at the Long Branch Middle School in the auditorium. The negotiations team has dedicated a significant amount of time in helping to provide a fair agreement that contains minimal concessions. We're looking forward to meeting with you during our informational sessions. As always, thank you for your continued support and dedication.
This change here allows the president to assign an additional designee to attend the district calendar meeting. In Article 3, additional days were added in the processing of grievances. In Article 2, Section C was removed as is no longer being used by either party. In Article 1, the job titles were updated. In Article 4, it deals with requests for transfers. They will now be filed electronically, going directly to the superintendent's office. And it also says that by September 30th, every employee shall be provided a written statement of their sick time. In Article 6, it now says that the association president may use the district email to communicate with members. The president shall also receive an official copy of the agenda, the board agenda, that includes termination and personnel issues. And it also says that representatives from the association on the county, state, and national level are allowed to visit the buildings. In Article 12, it talks about flex time, which allows an employee the opportunity to fill out a change of schedule 3 times a year upon supervisor's approval, and it will no longer than 2 hours at each request. Also in Article 12, it says that after 3 consecutive days because of illness, upon return, staff should have a doctor's note stating that they are fit to return to work at full duty. 12, which addresses benefits, tuition reimbursement. Section 1 was revised to say that members now take 6 credits. But it's very important to understand that provision sunsets, meaning when this agreement's over, we go back to 9 credits. Also, there have been timelines established for when you have to submit for course approval and to receive reimbursement. And you need to receive a B or a pass in order to, for reimbursement to be effective. Article 9 speaks to secretaries. All secretaries and clerks shall receive the days between Christmas and New Year's as holidays without using your vacation days and a maximum of 3 days. In Article 8, it says that professional development will be moved to Fridays and days before holidays. However, no time has been added to the workday. We still can leave at the same time the students leave on those days. Also in Article 8, the alternative school working conditions have been added to the contract. And also at the middle school and the high school, all those teachers who have been teaching five periods, they will continue to teach five periods with no more than three different subject preparations. And all teachers teaching six periods will have six periods with no more than two subject preparations. In any case that a six-period teacher teaches an additional subject prep, they shall receive a $4,500 pensionable stipend. Instructional time at the middle school is capped at 270 minutes, and the instructional time at the high school has been capped at 264 minutes. Also in Article 8, Section E, flex time, job titles were modified, and it's still voluntary. That's very important to understand. It's still voluntary. No working hours can be changed without staff members' consent. Also, in Part 3 of the Workday and Responsibility, Part 3 was deleted. This was regarding whole school reform. Also in Section D, Part 4 was modified to read that the number of required meetings shall not exceed 4 30-minute meetings per month. Now here it's important to note, the board wanted additional meetings. We just took the current time and split it up once a week for 30 minutes. Also, adding to all the sections, we have language now that protects your prep period. Also added to all the sections, during the first 2 days of school, teachers are allotted up to 3 hours for classroom preparations. And also in Section F, Section 1 was deleted, which dealt with SFA, which we no longer use. Article 10, changes to Article 10 are significant. Workday, now the employees will receive 2 15-minute breaks before and after their lunch dinner period. Job protection has been added back into this contract. Termination cannot be without just cause. Also, seniority will be used to determine overtime, and additional contributions for members to the health insurance are no longer required. Changes to salary guides. The teacher's salary guide, unfortunately, has a very large increment cost, 9%. Now, these increment costs were a result of the previous salary guides from the prior negotiations. And due to these large increment costs, movement had to be frozen during the first and second year. However, during the first and second year, every teacher's salary increases. In year one, everyone receives a raise over $1,000, and in year two, everyone receives a raise over $1,200. In the third year, all teachers advance one step on the guide. Now, the alternative choice we had was to add 6 steps to the salary guide, inserting a step between 10 and 11, between 11 and 12, between 12 and 13, between 13 and 14, between 14 and 15, and between 15 and 16. Our 16-step guide would then be 22 steps. The negotiations team decided this was not the best choice for the guides. Now, some units have salary guides that have a low increment cost, such as the secretaries and the school safety employees. Because their guides have low increment costs, they were able to move one step on the guide each year of the agreement. Custodians and grounds, your guides also had an increment cost issues, and a step had to be added as needed. In addition, the prior negotiations members were put on a separate guide based on the year of hire. During this round of negotiations, we condensed the guides into one for each position. One guide for the 12-month custodians, one guide for the 10-month custodians, and one guide for maintenance. Stipends. After more than 10 years of frozen stipends, this negotiation team successfully bargained additional money to stipends. Unfortunately, not all stipends will see a raise. Yearly stipends will see a slight increase, as well as athletics.
I hope this video has helped you answer some of your questions that you might have had about this contract. At the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, it's a good contract. Buildings and ground, we got job protection put back into the agreement. This negotiation team fought very hard to correct the wrongs of the previous agreement, specifically for that department. We got additional days off for our secretaries so they can spend time with their families around the holidays. They don't have to use their vacation time anymore. Teachers, we got protected preps in there. We have the quality of your working environment has improved. We fought very hard. The board wanted us to have more meetings during the day after contractual hours. We stood firm. We said no. Our members already put in the extra mile. They don't need to stay longer, taking away time from their families as well. We put in language in there that has never been cleaned up in 15, 18 years. This contract has done it. I'm also speak to you too about our salary guides. Now, I did go over that earlier, but I got to remind you, the board initially proposed 4.5% with a hard cap on tuition reimbursement. We got them to 6.9. Now, again, the board was at 4.5. We settled for 6.9. We didn't roll over and take 4.5. We fought hard for our members. Now, listen, unfortunately, our salary guide has a huge increment cost, 9%. And, that's something we're going to, moving forward, we need to address. We need to fix. So the guides that I went over earlier today, they're the best. And, voting this contract down doesn't settle anything. We go back a step. We go back to last year's salary. You're frozen. All that contract language, which hasn't been done in 18 years, it all remains. It stays the same. So look at it in the bigger picture. It's a good contract, and I need you to support it. Thanks.